I worked in a corrupt drug and alcohol rehab for 5 years. Corruption is everywhere, from patients using with staff members to staff members having affairs. Before I got hired, the guy that interviewed me appeared to be under the influence of stimulants. A lot of the patients that came in knew staff members because they were friends, or maybe even they used together a long time ago. And unfortunately, a lot of those workers relapsed. I don't know how many people I've talked through suicidal ideation. They're on their last breath of hope. And to come to a place that prioritized money and business over their life, it was sickening. We actually had one instance where a 19-year-old boy was rushed through the program for the sake of giving up their bed to somebody else who could pay cash or had better insurance. He was sent home and overdosed 2 days later and died. The facility that I worked at was at minimum $1,000 per day and was in network and approved by a lot of major insurance companies in California. But working on the inside, it felt like just a bunch of people who were newly sober trying to figure out how to run a business. There was one instance where we had a staff member who relapsed and quit, and they got back into the addiction lifestyle. They were dealing drugs. They were a connect for somebody who was in the rehab. That person knew where to drop it off, where it wouldn't be found, and a patient overdosed because of that. It was definitely just a big ball of chaos. The inpatient manager was actually notorious for gossiping about what patients disclosed in private one-on-one sessions. There was one time that I was at one of the houses and he was reading somebody's therapy note. He pushed the keyboard back and he sat back and he said, "Man, if she wasn't patient, I'd totally fuck her. She definitely takes it in the ass." We also had a program director who attempted patient brokering. Patient brokering is when somebody at a facility is basically doing a backdoor deal for cash and gets a percentage of the cut of whoever they can bring in for treatment. It has been known that patient brokering does take place in the rooms of Alcoholics and Narcotics Anonymous. People will go in and basically just start asking people, "Hey, who's got health insurance?" The screening process consisted of a mini biopsychosocial assessment where you collected medical history, abuse history, drug use history. A lot of the people that were answering the phones were not qualified or certified, including myself. These people had no clinical experience, no clinical credentials, and a lot of the time, not even a high school diploma. A lot of the questions were really triggering, especially when we would get to the section about abuse. The more sick a person was, the better chance their insurance would pay for them to stay longer. So you're constantly battling between picking this person apart or letting them have their dignity or not doing your job. The insurance department was under a lot of pressure from the CEO to bill for as much time as they could. The clinical department was trying to treat people who came there for help. There was one instance where the insurance director started yelling obscenities at the clinical director because they wanted to keep a patient longer than the clinical director wanted to. It always felt like it was profit over people. It's heartbreaking. At one point, two of the managers were having an affair. They would disappear to take lunches together and be gone for hours or be locked in one of the offices. They weren't able to be disturbed. Ultimately, it made the patient suffer. I was in a constant battle with my own moral compass and my desire to help people, hoping that the next day will be different. I was having panic attacks at work. I would lock myself in my office and just cry. It takes an emotional toll on you to be in such a toxic work environment. And then the kind of work that we're doing is so heavy. We had no support. I knew I had to leave. To anybody who's looking to get help for themselves or for somebody they love, pay attention to what's between the lines. If you don't ask any questions, you'll be blindly led down this yellow brick road that doesn't exist. Regulators need to have a better grip on what's going on in these facilities. I think the more that addiction is treated as a medical problem, as the disease that it is, the less these things will happen.